Power and economy depend on the basic mechanical condition of the engine. To perform some engine diagnostic tests, you will need a vacuum gauge. No amount of carburetor, ignition, or exhaust work will make up for burned valves, leaking head gaskets, or worn piston rings. The following tests and inspections will help you locate mechanical problems in the engine that may cause rough running, lack of power, or hard starting.
Begin by connecting the gauge to a full manifold vacuum source. You could use a vacuum T on an existing line or pull a line such as one that leads to a transmission or emissions control unit. Don't use the side port located on the metering block of any Holley carburetor. This is a timed port that will only show full vacuum at higher RPMs. From here, you can either select one of the gauge numbers if you're familiar with the video, or just wait for the guided tour of all gauge reading descriptions. Keep in mind, when we refer to a normal vacuum reading, we're talking about a reading on an engine in sound mechanical condition that's being checked at a sea level elevation. For elevations around 3,000 feet and above, your gauge readings may be slightly lower, but will have the same reactions as shown. The following are some typical gauge readings and what each indication means. A steady reading between 16 and 22 inches at idle is normal for most mildly cammed to stock engines. Radically cammed engines will inherently have a lower and less steady reading. A normal range at idle, with sporadic drops below normal, might indicate some valves are sticking. A normal range at idle, with a needle vibration of about 2 inches, may indicate an ignition problem. Check the spark plugs and gaps, the plug wires, the distributor cap and rotor, the distributor dwell setting, and the coil connection itself. A steady reading that's slightly higher than a previously noted normal reading might be caused by a dirty air filter or an overly advanced ignition timing. A steady reading at 3 to 12 inches lower than normal may indicate one or more of the following conditions: an intake, carburetor, or vacuum system air leak, a late ignition or cam timing setting, or worn piston rings.